Welcome everybody to episode number 100 of Flower Circus Talks. 100, what a number! And I must admit, I'm even a little bit nervous. So let's start. 100 Flower Circus Talks. I never imagined to get to this number. It all started at the end of March 2020. The whole world was on a standstill because COVID happened. We all had a lot of questions, more questions than answers. We had to cancel our planned tours and shows. I was calling friends. Friends were calling me, asking what's happening around the world. And that's when I decided to start with Flower Circus Talks. I came up with the idea to do Flower Circus Talks and go live and talk with everybody what was going on in the world, so people would know what was happening, and actually to do what we did with our shows as well, to connect and the flower industry, to inform and to inspire. I wrote it down because I know when I'm nervous I stop talking, so I need to read it a little bit. After calling friends, I could start the Flower Circus talks on a daily basis. I started with a Dutch chrysanthemum grower, and soon we went all over the world, even to China. And for me, China was one of the biggest reliefs during the whole pandemic, or the start of the pandemic, where Peter told us that the Chinese flower market was already starting up after 8-9 weeks again, and that they were on 80% of their capacity. So people were starting to buy flowers again, something we didn't know yet in Europe, because Europe was still in shock. I've been talking to a lot of different people from different countries, from growers, breeders, wholesalers, florists, designers, even people with e-commerce shops. All of them were filled with ideas, and they gave me, which they gave me, but hopefully you as well, watching all those shows. And it also gave me, and hopefully you as well, the strength to continue in those tough times. And I believe that we, if we stand together as an industry, we'll have a really bright future, even with all the challenges we get. I mean, we're with COVID, but probably, and hopefully not, but we will get some more challenges ahead. What the previous 99 talks taught me, that we have a very innovative industry. No matter how hard we get hit, we always find a way out. And now that more and more people realize we need a healthy lifestyle to protect us and to move on, I think we have a great chance with the flower and plant industry, because flowers and plants are part of that healthy lifestyle. They bring us joy. They bring us mental health. They cool down our apartments, and so on and so on. And I think we need to promote this, all those beneficial things. And we need to promote that together. It's not only Flower Circus. We've got the Flower Council in Holland and many other companies promoting those flowers. We just need to step up and promote the flowers. The world is changing fast. We have a lot of online things going on. Flowers don't sell themselves anymore as they used to do. And that's why I'm really proud that I have Marcel Zandvliet today from the Dutch Flower Group, telling more about this subject, because we need to move forward. We need to promote more. We need to do it together. Only then we can step up our game. And I think we will have a very, very bright future ahead of us. One last thing. I've never used Flower Circus Talks as a sales tool, but I think the 100 episode, I could advertise myself a little bit. What we do as Flower Circus is advertising growers, breeders, groups of growers. So if you're interested to join Flower Circus, please let me know after the show. And also, before I forget, that's something I normally always forget. If you like the stream, please put a like or follow us on YouTube, Facebook. That's something my team always blames me that I forget to talk or to say it, because of the interesting guest, and I just get into the guest and forget to say that. But now quickly, let's go to Marcel. Let's go to the talks. And there he is.
Yeah. Yeah, I think John, thank you very much for having me on your 100. I found a party hat, as we now, because we have a distance, we cannot have a drink or a coffee. But congratulations with your 100th talk, and very honored to be here today.
Yeah, thank you very much, and I'm honored that you are here. I mean, we talked about a lot of subjects, and all the time we came back to marketing, and that we see that we're selling more flowers, but I think we can sell way more flowers still. But we're not really into marketing yet, because still there's the understanding that flowers will sell themselves.
Mm-hmm. Shall I briefly introduce myself to the audience, because I don't know if a lot of people know me, John. So I'm Marcel Zandvliet. I'm 53 years old. I still feel younger, of course, but I am 53. And my, just for the record, but my grandfathers were both in the flower business. One was a flower trader, was okay. The grandfather of the Zandvliet, and the other grandfather was a rose grower, and also my uncles were a rose grower, all in the Aalsmeer area. And I also said, every time I did my studies, I don't want to end up in the flower industry, and now you see what happens. Yeah. But I did some marketing courses, and I worked for almost 20 years in the packaging business, also for flowers and plants, and 3 years in the flower food, and now 10 years with the Dutch Flower Group, and responsible for marketing and sustainability.
Yeah, and just for some of the people watching as well, marketing, that's way more than just making a brochure or a poster.
Yeah, and I think that's also why I'm very happy to be here today, John, because I think I did an interview, I think, about 2 weeks ago with HortiPoint. First in, I think, in 10 years that I really reached out to have an interview, because what I saw in talks with our growers, and especially with our growers abroad, a lot of people don't know what is happening behind everything that we do as Dutch Flower Group and our companies, but also I think a lot of people between ourselves, we don't know even what is happening. So I'm very happy to talk about a little bit more about marketing. And indeed, it's not just only promotion, or it's just having a brochure or show or something. It's really a combination of a lot of elements that you want to target on a audience. In this case, of course, our consumer, our end consumer. Yeah. And that's something I really want to chat about today, if I may.
Yeah, of course. That's why I invited you. I mean, you have a leading role in Holland in that part. So that's why I asked you.
Yeah.
I mean, you do a research every year as well, a consumer research. Why do you do it? I mean, you can just promote, or it doesn't work like that.
No, it doesn't really work like that. Now, I think one of the things, and that's what a lot of people think, is that when you think about flowers and plants, they sell themselves. And as we had, I think, our discussion last week, you also said, yeah, Marcel, but look at the figures and the facts. Still, the sales is after COVID. There's still COVID challenges all across the globe, but still you see the flower and plant business, you see it growing again. So why make fuss about promotion or marketing? And I think that it's always putting a little smile to my face, because a lot of people in other industries understand that the marketing efforts you do, and if you're a florist, you're a garden center, or you're one of the other players in this chain, everybody together makes that message. So if you don't talk about it anymore, it's the same as we wouldn't talk to one another. You don't know each other anymore, so you need to really put that in the mind of our consumers, and that's a difficult, very difficult challenge. So for us, I will not elaborate too much in now, but what we do every 2 years, we do a trend forecast, and we have specialized people who really have an agency looking not 10 years, but looking about 20 to 30 years ahead. And from that trend forecasting, we get the key drivers back, how consumers are influenced. So what are the key drivers of us Looking in our country, in or you're in Ukraine, or I'm in Holland, or I'm England, what are the key drivers that bring us the coming 10 to 20 years? At the last trend forecast I can share with everybody here is that from the four key drivers that are societal, that hit the consumer's mindset,
yeah,
and our attitude to flowers and plants, are that rewilding, so putting nature back in our atmosphere, in our working atmosphere, in our living atmosphere, and the health and well-being, as you addressed already in your introduction, that are very important drivers for the future. And yeah, it all comes back to where we are at this moment and what is coming to us. The big disruptor will be the climate change that is still there. And you think, yeah, looking at then your question about marketing, what has to do with us, this issue of climate change? It has all to do with that we are all driven to make nature more in our lives, yeah, integrated more in lives, I may say so. So if you talk about marketing, it starts with us with a trend forecast every 2 years, then to understand better what consumers are driven, we do a shopper segmentation research. And in 2013, 16 and 18, there was a coalition which Flora Holland, the auction, as you know, the Flower Council, and the VGB, the Dutch wholesale organization, they conducted that survey together and did the research together and invested in that. But in the COVID year, of course, everybody had their challenges, and it was said, the last one was in 2018, Marcel, we're not going to do it again because of all the challenges we already have. So we at the Flower Group said we need to do it because we have to see what the effects are, not only for us on the flower and plant sales today, but also how the attitude is changing in the 3 years from 2018. And to be honest, looking at what we got as a result from that, is that you see the major shopper groups, and we talk about the five countries here in Europe, so I'm not talking about America or Asia, but what you see is the three groups that already were important for the flower and plant sales are growing in their attitude, positive attitude, and that are the status seekers, so people who really like flowers because they want to really embrace it in their lives and show that you really have something in your interior that has a place, and flowers play a very important role. And the second group is the aesthetic explorer, and that's also a very important shopper group, where also the Flower Council is hitting with all their promotion campaigns on. Yeah. And the third one, and that's a logic one, I think, if we talk about plants also, is the nature carer. So if we look now to what happened 3 years ago and the position of the shopper groups and what we see with our customers, which is growing, which the segments that are growing, we see only opportunities, to be honest. And the only way to then translate that, we do 2 times a year a lifestyle and trend research, which we then, let's say, put in advance of 1 year for the season. And we, in this case, I provide this to my colleagues of design of all the DFG companies, 33 companies we have at this moment, to help our designers and our marketeers to make a translation on the research on the one hand, and then also for the trends that are coming, to put this in practice with the color of the flower, with the packaging used, to the concepts that we deliver then to our retailers. So it's maybe a long story, but to put it short, a lot of people don't know that when we talk to a grower or we talk to our end customer, retailer, like a supermarket chain, but it could also be a former or franchise company, that we have all this information on our back when we talk about, this would be our advice in your category to use this assortment and to have this flower in this time of year, etc. This is all used to make sure that we have the added value to that specific group.
Yeah, wow. And it works, I think, the other way around as well. I mean, with breeders, to tell the breeders, okay, we're going this way or it's going this way. I mean, some of the breeders, it takes 10, 20 years. So
yeah,
at
5 to 6 years. Yeah.
Okay. For hyacinths, it's 40 years, but okay, the trend in 40 years, that's a little bit too difficult.
Yeah, now I think I'll have my pension plan. I hope.
Yeah.
No, you're right, John. But the difficulty today, to be honest, it sounds so logic to do, but it still is a very complex system, because as you say, a breeder, but it's not just one breeder, of course.
No.
We have there are major breeders, but there are still a lot of breeders of different niche products, and we need niche products. And we need also to make a combination with growers all across the globe, in our case, that really understand that and make sure that we channel it. In Dutch we say kanaliseren, we channel that to the right customer, and that to bring that together, that's the major challenge of marketing, to make sure that that fit will be there, and that needs a lot of effort, energy, and also money.
Yeah, and the right message to the right people. You can just send out a message, but if you don't know for whom it is, it's going to cost you a lot of money and there's no results at all.
Exactly. And that's also what I explained when we had our talk before, is that when we have that, we call it then the NPD, the new product development, but we try to take everybody in the chain together. The difficulty is then to make sure that you hit the right shopper in that segment, in that retail formula. And of course, if florists are listening to this today, and you're headed in Miami, for example, you have a different shopper group in your store than our online customer that we have, which, for example, has a UK-based shopper group, because people have a different orientation, a different attitude, a different feel to it, that you have to understand. So without also knowing from the people in store and using the data that you have, and it sounds very big, but it's very small. If you use that, then you're a winner for the future. If you don't use that, then it ends up with nothing. So you need everything in the whole chain to make sure that's a success.
I mean, it's you said it right. It's everybody has his own attitude, and that's why you segmentate it in different groups of people as well. And every group needs a different approach as well. I mean, it's like in different countries, you don't speak Dutch and French because they will not understand you.
Correct. I think that's good. And also, some colors have a symbolic value, as you know, in the flower business, in the plants, the shape of flowers and plants. So it's so much, and the Flower Council in the past had made a very thorough strategy in which they said, don't look at, let's say, the traditional way of selling the flowers and plants, but try to use the moments more.
Yeah.
So moments when you share with your friends, when you're sitting down for dinner, that's a very important moment. So instead of using a bottle of wine, bringing a bottle of wine to the table as a present. So that type of things, to connecting friends, make sure that when you have a season, to celebrate the season. Yeah. So then every product also which we have, we don't talk about a hyacinth or a rose or a tulip. We talk about then that moment, and then everybody also can use the same message and sell that story to the consumer, because at the end, we all deliver to the same consumer in that area where you're at, in which segment you already are. So we talk to the same shopper.
Yeah, I think in the end, if you look at Flower Council Holland, we just need to reach the consumer, and then we need to have general promotion. As a breeder or a grower, yes, you can promote your products by name, because a florist, a wholesaler, knows the characteristics of that certain type of flower. They work on that. But the consumers, in the end, they will go for a bunch of flowers, or they will go for a plant. They've got no idea what the name is of the rose or the chrysanthemum or the gerber. So I think with promotion, you also need to look where you are, for whom you're promoting as well.
Yeah, but that's true. Yeah, it's true.
And talking about Flower Council Holland, there's a big discussion going on at the moment in Holland, unfortunately, I must say.
Mm-hmm.
How do you look at the whole thing that growers pay via Flora Holland? They pay a percentage that's 0.2 or 0.19, which is... if we look at other industries, let's not compare it with other industries, because that's way off. But we have the discussion, because not every grower trades via Flora Holland.
Mm-hmm.
How do you look at that? How do you look at the whole discussion?
Now, I think that in essence, I think, as we said, you need to have an institute or organization that makes sure that the top of mind awareness of flowers and plants, the importance of flowers and plants in our lives as a consumer, there needs to be someone in this world doing that. Yeah. I think that's no discussion. I think for nobody. If you would say we do that fragmented, and it has been, of course, not for coincidence that the Dutch founded that Flower Council Holland, is that we work together, we collectively get the funding, then we can really target with research that top of mind awareness that we need. So we have campaigns for that. So everybody can then use that freely to also bring the same message across. So one voice and one message. And the discussion that now arises is something I know that it's about the administrative part of how to collect the money.
Yeah.
I think if you should search for an alternative, that will be very difficult. I know from my experience from the years which I've been in this industry. And I think it is also so little that in the whole discussion, I think 1.2%, because talk about percent,
yeah,
that's on the top of everything. I think it's really an administrative discussion. It's not about the essence of why we need the Flower Council and why we need that collective promotion.
Yeah.
But I think also that the big challenge would be if that really would be by Flora Holland a decision in the coming week, that they would decide to not do this at this way anymore. I think we would lose this very important institute for this industry. And yeah, also in the Flower Group, I'm not able to just make a collective approach to all our customers with all the research done. I do a part which I can do and can invest in, but collectively we need one another to really bring that same message, that one voice and that one message based on the same segmentation, information and research. And I think, yeah, that's really how I feel about it and also how DFG looks at it. So we would really be very, yeah, sorry if it would be ending and that it would not be administratively be taken like that in the future. Yeah.
Caroline is saying the worst thing that happened in the UK was the stopping of our penny in the pound levy used for PR and marketing. It was a big mistake, and I hope growers Flora Holland don't make the wrong decision.
Yeah.
I mean,
and I think, John, as I said, I think there's nobody discussing about the essence that we need Flower Council or we need a collective promotion, but it's the how to find the money and do the administrative part. So if we keep that a little bit different from one another, I think we still look at the positive side.
Yeah,
there is still a Flower Council, there is campaigning, and we need to be acting with what we do now, also for the future. As I said, there's so many opportunities that we already have from our research, and our DFG companies, of course, use this to bring success and growth with our customers in the categories that we have under our guidance. We're very proud to do so, but we need to use it more in the whole sector and not just...
Yeah, and worldwide, I think. That's also, it's Flower Council Holland, but... if it's up to me, just skip the Holland part and let's go worldwide. I mean, we started Flower Council Holland when Holland was a big producing country, but we've got Africa, we've got South America, Asia, of course, as well.
Yeah.
I mean, we are competing with a bottle of wine, we're competing with perfume, chocolates. And if you see what they spend, what they have a marketing budget, I looked it up. The average is 10.4% of the net revenue they are spending. 10.4%.
Yeah.
And flowers don't sell themselves anymore. Not online. Online, everything looks good. Even I look good online. So, and that's I think not the mistake we made, but that's something we can still improve. I mean, that's the positive thing. Just look at other industries, what they are doing. And I'm not saying that we now have to spend 10% for marketing. We've got flowers. We can get into newspapers quite easily because we don't have a brand. So if a newspaper has some space left, we can, Flower Council was doing, Plant of the Month, Flower of the Month. It's easy to be in the newspaper like this. And if we skip that, then... we lose that space, and some other industry will say thank you. It's like with the Pope getting flowers to the Pope. I mean, the guy who figured that one out, great guy. I mean, millions of people are watching all over the world. And it's not only famous in Holland when he says thank you for the flowers. Everybody all over the world, even where we go with Flower Circus, they tell what you do there with the flowers, with the Pope, that's marketing-wise, that's the best thing ever.
Yeah, but I think you're so right. And I think, to have your 100th circus talk today and be right with one another, I think it only understates the discussion we have about how marketing can play a role, a positive role, in changing also consumer attitudes towards flowers and plants. And yeah. I think our challenge together, and it's together with all the listeners and viewers today, is to find ways to really be more collectively approaching this. Because it's not something that I want to change, that we think more top of mind to buy flowers when you go to France. I think you would be asking the same. And maybe somebody would say, yeah, I'd rather have them here in my shop in Miami. And other one would say, yeah, I would love to have them online here for that, let's say, birthday present they want to click on, etc. But it's all for the same cause. And I think... we talked about what, Marcel, what would you like to see in future? I really would like, as we have a purpose, as you know, John, and our purpose is to together create a happier and greener world. And it's so simple, but that's, I think, what about 95, maybe 100% of the people in this business want, because you're driven through the passion they have for this beautiful product where nature is all around you every day. You want to bring that on. And I think we forget in all the challenges we have is to cooperate and to make sure that we bring that same. And maybe you would benefit this case a little bit more or less, but it doesn't matter. As long as we cooperate to make that to make this something of all of us and not fight one another in this industry, I think we're having a very bright future.
Yeah, it's just look outside the industry. Look what people are doing, what they are buying, why they are buying it. And don't fight each other because this week people are buying a freesia and next week they probably buy a tulip.
Look so to the consumer. Yeah, follow the consumer. Yeah.
It's just to get into people's minds that they reserve a certain amount for flowers, hopefully even weekly. We see what's happening in the United States. People start to buy flowers for themselves. And the whole world is upside down, or especially if you look at South America. People don't know what's happening because people start to buy flowers and for themselves. Yeah. I mean, and then we're talking about the United States. It's just beginning. But can you imagine if other countries will follow as well? I mean, Russia is still a country that they buy for holidays and special occasions.
Occasions, yeah.
I mean,
But I think, in essence, I think without the marketing, without collectively approaching this, we will, let's say, take not too much of the opportunities that are there. And as I say already, what I shared with you in the research we did, we see so much positive sides together with the attitude of the consumer to grow together, that I think it's also now the time to take that up and to make sure that we collectively as a business try to address this. And I thank you for the time that I could spend now today with your viewers and be here. And looking at the time, I think we have about 1 minute left. So I leave it up to you to close it now, John.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you so much for joining today. I mean, it's special. They sent me a video, so I will show it in a minute. I've got no idea what it is, so I'm a bit. That's why I'm a bit nervous today. Normally, it's more. I know what's happening, but this time it's different.
No, I think it's a surprise. It's a surprise day for you.
Yeah, it really is. I think standing together, that's something we learned throughout the whole COVID period. That's something we should do. And okay, maybe this week your neighbor is selling more flowers because of the promotion. Next week, it's your turn. We just need to stand together. Don't look at each other in envy, but okay, let's stand together as an industry. As an industry, we can make it work. Let people buy flowers, tell the message. I mean, there are so many researches that flowers are good for your mental health, for recovery, and so many things. Those researches go back 50 years. We never used it. We never had to use it, probably. But now is the time really to use it because...
Exactly. Yeah.
And it's easy, or we have so many channels now. We've got online, offline. So it's easier than ever to reach the customer. We can get into their most precious possession. That's their phone. We get in there into their phones nowadays. So that's really easy, and we should do it, and we should do it together.
Yeah, fully agree. So thank you, and again, congratulations on your 100th.
Yeah, thank you very much.
And hope also for you a bright future with the Flower Circus, John. And yeah, let's play the video. I thank all the audience, and hope to see you soon in live.
Yeah, okay. Hope to see you soon, especially now that the exhibitions are starting again. So really yeah. Great. Thank you very much for your time, Marcel.
Okay, see you. Bye-bye.
So that was Marcel. Really great to hear what's happening, and that marketing is way much more than just sending out brochures. Get to know your customers. Caroline is saying as well, collaboration is essential and no one can do it on their own. Alison is saying we need to share the passion. I mean, that's so important. And now a moment, I've got no idea what's happening. First, I want to thank my team, Flower Circus. Most of the time you will see my face, but there's a whole team behind the Flower Circus. Thank you for getting me through the whole difficult times as well, helping me out, getting guests, cheering me up when I was down and thought we're never going to travel again. Luckily, we traveled and had our first show again last weekend in France. So hopefully we will see you live soon again. And now it's time to start the video. So let's see what we're going to see here.
Yeah! Today is a special day.
My God, it's your birthday. 100 today. Oh, congratulations. Oh, no, not your birthday.
Congratulations on the 100th episode of Flower Circus Talks.
John, congratulations to your 100th episode at the Flower Circus.
Congratulations on the 100th Flower Talks.
Congratulations with your 100th episode of Flower Talks.
Congratulations for your video number 100.
Congratulations, my friend, 100 episodes.
Wanted to say congratulations on your 100th episode.
We're here at the Doyoki Institute to bring these beautiful Ponamora roses because they are celebrating the people of more than 100 years.
Congratulations with this amazing milestone, 100 episodes of super promotion for our horticulture sector.
Spot on, you did. Now the whole world knows your ugly face with your circus director head on.
100 episodes. I can't believe it. It doesn't seem, a day since you started it. But oh boy, what did you start?
What started as a tryout, because you couldn't organize any live shows, has become a serious and interesting program to follow with all your international guests.
You know, Corona came, and I must say there is a saying that says losers always will have excuses, but real entrepreneurs, they will always have solutions.
It has been a very difficult time the last year and a half, but you made it, and I'm proud of being part of Flower Circus.
You started something in the darkest of the times when we all needed support, when we all needed something different to look at.
That is amazing. It takes a whole lot of work to keep it going and a whole lot of passion to keep it going. So thank you for that, for sharing all the great information and connecting people throughout our industry.
Thanks for bringing us, florists and growers, together in the wonderful world of flowers.
I really appreciate everything you do for the flower industry to combine, get us all together and show what different parts of the world are doing.
Sean is very passionate about the mission to tell the florists worldwide that they have to buy Dutch flowers.
All the last period of 2 years, John and team of Flower Circus was very nearby to florists, very nearby to growers, and all industry of floristry every week.
During COVID, you started the Flower Talks as well, and I very much appreciated that I could also join from Poland.
I was part of the Flower Circus Talks more than once, and I like what you do. I like the discussions that you have, and I like the explanation that you give to florists and wholesalers all around the globe.
So just 100 interviews, back to back, wall to wall, with every technical difficulty under the sun.
I want to thank you for everything, all the fun we had, this really great inventive project we did.
You have connected people from all over the world. You had some fabulous guests, and of course I'm going to include myself in that.
To tell you a little story, you know I am Wouter Duivenstein, but we make the first edition, so I was your test rabbit. And you started to ask me some questions, and then you tell me, okay Wouter, go inside your greenhouse and tell some story. So I did, and then it happened. Wi-Fi disconnected. The show was going on. You tell the people some funny stories, and this is how you are, Sean. You just improvise. You inform. You are funny. You find good people around you.
I was also part of one of the flower talks. I really liked it, and me and especially the whole team of Florismart Direct want to congratulate you on this huge effort.
I was lucky enough to be part in one of those episodes, and I'm wishing you all the best for the future.
I wish you all the best of luck. I can't wait to see another 100 episodes.
I wish you all the best for the future. I know you have a lot of plans in your head, and I know you will work them out.
Keep going with the good energy and good vibes that you have, because it's just amazing and the show are always good and a lot of fun, a lot of friends, and it's great. So keep going, and I wish you all the best.
Have a great success, have new guests, new viewers, and a lot of new achievements and highs, and much more sleep. I wish you to have that.
Long may it continue. Many, many congratulations.
I want to say, keep up the good work and good luck.
You know, I love you very much. I have the utmost respect for you. Congratulations.
And you're certainly the best circus director in the world.
I have a big respect for you.
Well done, and keep up doing the good work of giving us more background information of our fantastic industry.
I wish you and all team of Flower Circus health, happiness and good success for all projects that you plan for the future.
Keep up the good work, and I hope to be part of it again soon.
Happy 100 recording. Congratulations. You are doing a great job. We've been very happy to be part of your Flower Circus family. Regards from South Africa.
Hope you're well. And please tell me the neighbor has stopped building whatever he is building next door to you.
You know how they explain Einstein's relativity theory? A 1 hour lap dance of a young girl seems like a minute. A 1 minute lap dance by an old wife seems like an hour. 100 times a flower circus talk seems like just 1 minute. Congratulations.
Looking forward to more episodes from the Flower Circus, and all the best.
Congratulations. Congratulations. And of course,
confetti.
Can't miss that one.
Flower Circus. Flower Circus. Everybody gather around. The Flower Circus is in town. Everybody come and sit down. The Flower Circus is in town. Flower Circus!
Hey John, 100 episodes, that's pretty cool. I gotta catch up with you.
Oh, thank you so much. Goosebumps, really. Nice to see to have so many nice friends all over the world. And that makes us keep on doing this. Thank you, Anna. I think you had a monstrous job to get all the videos and to gather it to make a nice video out of it. Hope you get some sleep too now. Without words, thank you everybody for watching. Thank you everybody for the really nice videos, and we will keep on going with our Flower Circus talks. Thank you very much. Have a nice weekend.